preparing for last. Yes, sir. I have started preparing for last 2 years, and in 2020 I had given the prelims and several
2018.
mock tests also in different institutes.
No, which year
no,
did
sir,
you give the prelims?
2020, last year.
Acha, acha, acha. Okay.
2020, okay. Last year.
Ha, ha, ha. Fine, fine. Go
and
ahead.
I'm working in a private sector organization, so
okay.
I hardly get time to manage my routines and schedules. So
okay.
It gets tougher, you know, complete the whole syllabus in a short span of time. So my question was in this way, that how should I manage myself? And being out of my city for last 3 years, I have to manage myself of my own everything. So from my food, my staying, everything I had to manage for myself. So my sincere question is to you that how should I prepare and how should I use minimum of resources to get maximum output?
Okay. Okay. Question is basically about managing UPSC preparation with a job, to be more specific, a private job. And it becomes 1 degree more difficult when you say that the job is outside your home city. So that means that, you know, you're losing your comfort zone. So usually in such situations, you know, the universal remedy, or I would say the universal prescription for people who are trying to attempt this exam with a job, is to give one sincere attempt with as much time as possible. So this is the you know, the real ingredient, that whoever is planning to you know, take the exam along with a job, he or she should give at least one attempt, you know, as far as possible, full time. Theek hai. So if you are appearing, since you have already started and you are already in your job, this will not be applicable for you. So in such a situation, what you should be doing is, you know, first though, you have to accept your reality first. Theek hai. So firstly, you have to accept your reality that this cannot change. Now, if you are firm on this aspect that you will not leave the job and you are going to continue with it, so you have to convince yourself that the preparation has to be done within whatever time schedule you have. Okay. Now, the biggest roadblock that comes for most people in a job is that even before starting the preparation or even before appearing for the exam, they are mentally defeated, thinking that, you know, it's not possible simply because I'm not allotting enough time. But the good thing that I can you know, I can tell you at this point of time is that UPSC, the, you know, the requirements of UPSC, the you know, the recent changes that have come, you can definitely see a certain amount of latitude that is being given to people who do not have that much time at their disposal. Okay, so earlier what used to happen was UPSC was always you know, we traditionally have associated UPSC with you know, 5-6 years of preparation and then you clear the exam. Right now that is not the case. Okay, so a person who is preparing for 6 months, 7 months has equal chance of clearing the exam as a person who has been preparing for 6 years. So the competition has been leveled out. And the reason is every year in prelims or in mains, there is some kind of a surprise. There is some kind of a, you know, a change in pattern, a change in approach, which keeps aspirants on their toes. So because of that, the competition is very mixed. It is not biased in favor of those who are preparing full time or those who have been preparing for 5-6 years. So this is the first thing that you need to convince yourself right at the very beginning. Okay, so the problem is that most people don't, you know, they are not able to tell themselves this thing firmly. And because of that, they struggle. Okay, they struggle, they, you know, they are kind of limping throughout the preparation. So pehle to aap decide kar lijiye ki aapko job ke saath dena hai, theek hai? Because otherwise what happens is, you know, 1 year down the line, again, you will think, I have wasted another attempt. So, you know, should I leave a job or something? So address those questions right now itself. Okay. Right now is the time to address those questions. And in your job, try and find a specific schedule. Theek hai? It can be 7 hours. It can be 8 hours. It can be anything. Okay. The real problem of preparing with a job is not the schedule as such. It's the real problem comes when the schedule is uncertain. Okay. So you should, you know, you know, you should talk to your boss or whoever is there and try and find that certainty in your schedule. Okay, so when you can find that certainty, what you should do is you can draw up your plan. Now, this is where the real game is, because when you are drawing up your plan, you have to keep a lot of things in mind. Keep in mind that, you know, some days you may not be able to commit, you know, as much time as possible. Some days you will be sick. Some days something else will happen. So it has to be a very flexible schedule. Okay. And the other thing is that do not quantify your preparation at this point of time. Do not start quantifying it and comparing yourself with others, because if you quantify, you are going to be a clear loser, because there are people who will be preparing 6-7 hours for the next 1 year. In your case, you will be able to commit at the most 3-4 hours in a day, and you know, maybe 8-10 hours in the weekend. So do not quantify your preparation right now. Instead, start with a bit of, you know, quality addition and focus on the quality itself. So these are the few, I would say, the few soft aspects of preparation that that people preparing with job should keep in mind, because the other the theoretical parts, like which book to read, which which notes to read, or which test series to attempt, those things remain the same. It's just that the orientation or the way you approach your preparation, approach the exam, that needs to, that needs to be streamlined based upon the requirements of your job. And there are many people, okay, there are many people, if it's a list of 700, 800 successful candidates that comes up, you can be sure that at least there are at least 200 people who are clearing it with a job, okay, full-time job. That era of, full-time UPSC preparation, that era is gone. Okay, right now, most people are clearing with job. Okay, so keep that in mind and go on full steam. Okay.